Myer is the latest retailer to fall victim, closing its doors for the first time in its history. 10,000 workers are being stood down, but as Emily Rice tells us, trade hasn't stopped altogether.
Myer has been trading for 120 years, withstanding war, recessions and the Great Depression. But the pandemic has now forced the Victorian-founded company's department stores to shut up shop from tomorrow night.
Myer is an Australian icon, and the people that work in Myer are so proud of the business that they work for. And today, they're looking at an empty hole.
10,000 staff nationally are being stood down without pay for at least a month. Workers are reluctant to comment, leaving customers to express their dismay.
I don't know how people are going to survive, really. It's pretty devastating.
Clothing alteration business owner Irene relies on Myer and other retailers for customer referrals, and she's already struggling.
Very sad. Very sad. My last customers come pick up this morning and close down.
Myer's online business will continue to operate, and its returns policy will also be relaxed in an effort to retain some level of trade. And following suit today, Country Road, Cotton On and Witchery all announcing indefinite closure of their bricks and mortar stores.
Over the last 10 days or thereabouts, we have not seen a lot of traffic going into what we call discretionary spend.
The SDA union, which represents retail workers, is calling for an urgent government-funded wage subsidy.
Without a wage subsidy, the welfare bill is going to be larger and it's going to go on for longer.
But it seems there's no buying our way out of this health crisis.
I don't think we'll touch the tip of the iceberg yet.
Emily Rice, Nine News.